how we know we had a macroburst or a microburst, and how we didn't know it was a tornado. Because a lot of people, they walk outside, they see the damage, and they go, tornado.
Right.
Easy. But there's a way to find out.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And often, the straight line wind damage can be mistaked for the tornado damage just based on the way the debris is lying. But there's a distinct difference between the two. So how do you get a microburst? Well, as Alex just explained, microburst, macroburst, those are all different kinds of downbursts. Downbursts are the downdrafts out of the thunderstorm. They actually initiate well above in the atmosphere. This is drier air that gets wrapped in and entrained inside the thunderstorm. This dry air gives the raindrops inside an opportunity to evaporate. And that evaporation takes energy out of the atmosphere, which actually cools it down. So then what ends up happening is that you start generating some colder air into the thunderstorm, but then it's going to want to sink out because it becomes heavy. And so you get this very strong rushing wind outside of a thunderstorm, which when it hits the ground, it can't go anywhere. It can't punch through the surface, so it turns and has to go out. That's why we get divergent winds at the surface, which is like a tidal wave here, knocking down these trees. So notice, they're all laid down in basically the same direction because they all received that wind at the same time. And so they felt it and then boom, fell down, because these winds could be in excess of 100 miles per hour. And that macroburst was 125 miles per hour this weekend.
Very, very intense winds. So you can have the equivalent wind speed in a microburst / macroburst versus a tornado. The difference is when you look at the way the damage is strewn. You know, we talk about toothpicks last hour, and if you had all those toothpicks lined up, then you'd have a microburst. If it looked like you just dumped the box out and all the toothpicks were splayed in different directions, that would be more in line with what we'd see with tornado damage.
Yeah, definitely. There was a game we used to play called Pickup Sticks as kids, and that's exactly what it looks like. It's just all over the place because these are violent, very strong winds. So this happens in the wake of the tornado. Here's the tornado here that's moved on. But notice you have all these trees down in the process, but they don't have that same pattern, really. They're just kind of strewn about here in any random direction. That's because you have such a localized area of very strong and violent winds, which basically can just whip everything and even throw it miles from the actual place of the tornado. So it's really hard to distinguish where that came from, but the organization of the pattern for straight line winds really gives it away.
Yeah, in a matter of a couple feet, you can have a different wind direction there in that tornado. So fascinating stuff, and those crews that go out there and survey those sites have a lot of like weather CSI to do.
Totally.
Dr. Navarro, thanks so much. We've got much more ahead on Weather Underground Winter. Well, the future of solar power could be right under our feet. Tomorrow's smart, sustainable highway is being built right now. Take a look in the right direction to get power restored for a group that really could use it there at that Children's Hospital. Here in San Juan, we've got more rain chances coming in the upcoming 5 days than sunshine. Friday, the only dry day. Temps into the 80s, but notice those heat index values into the 90s. Same story for St. Croix. This is also an area in the U.S. Virgin Islands hit very hard. More rain than sun this week. Still hot, though, with highs in the 80s and feels like temperatures into the 90s. In the Atlantic, we've got a new area of interest to talk about tropic-wise. Not, Dr. Navarro, something that we need to worry about making an effect or having an effect in the Caribbean or the islands, but just another stat to add to our list for this busy season.
Yeah, just adding a